The best way to learn about tactics in Football Manager is to experiment. And I've been experimenting. So I've made similar videos about wingbacks, and I've made similar videos about strikers. Would highly recommend that you check those videos out, because if you find this one interesting, you're gonna love those. We're gonna break down how to get goals from wingers and why you are able to get goals from wingers. Because in my tactic on my Twitch save with Oriental Dragon, we have had one winger for two seasons now. The way we set our team up is as follows. Reese is going to do a couple of cool, super close-up, quick cuts to make my tactic look cooler than it is, right? But it's a 4-3-3. It's an offset 4-3-3 with essentially two more forward players and a winger who is facilitating, you know, taking names and so on and so forth. In this winger spot, we've tried out three different roles. We've used wingers, we've used inside forwards, and we have used inverted wingers. Now, I've covered in kind of brief moments what these different types of wingers do, and I'm going to make a different segment about playmakers. So if you're thinking about, like, you know, your well, advanced playmakers out here, or maybe your Trequartistas or your wide target men, then this isn't the video for you. What we're going to talk about is the different types of plays that you get from wingers, inside forwards, and inverted wingers. We will start with what we have had happen most recently, and that is the emergence of Angel Zamudio. And if you play Football Manager a lot, you are familiar with someone like Angel Zamudio, and more specifically, someone whose skill set mainly encompasses the ability to do this. Meow. As an example, right? This is somebody that has dribbling, they've got the athleticism to just carry the ball forward, and everything else is going to be secondary. Obviously, he has some good other skills because, well, our team is good. But he is a traditional, classic, out-and-out winger type of player in Angel Zamudio, who previously did not fit into our team. But the way that we've managed to get goals out of a winger position required a little bit of tinkering, but it's been very effective. Let me show you what it looks like in practice. This is a Europa League knockout match against Werder Bremen. What we are going to do is watch Angel Zamudio for this entire play to understand how we have our winger on attack playing. This is a winger on attack mentality that is playing right now. Let's get a different view. I feel like that would help us out. So we are going to go from a data analyst view, and this is Angel Zamudio right here. This is a winger on attack, and they are in possession. My right back takes the ball away, and Zamudio is filling the channel early, is able to receive the ball, and is opening up space for the rest of the team to get forward. We play on a lower tempo, so he's not exactly looking to press. He's not exactly looking for an extremely direct ball. This is a bit more of a possession-based system. Now, what you'll notice is that even though he is a winger on attack, he's picking the ball up and heading towards the middle of the field. Now, there are obviously things that you can do to help contribute this, but this is not the sort of movement that you would normally associate with a winger. Some of the things that can affect this are individual personal traits, like if you have somebody that carries the ball through the middle or switches the ball to their left foot before dribbling, but you're playing them as a winger on the right, well, they're not going to lose what makes them them. They're still going to do that sort of thing. Or in this case, we play a narrow system, and that makes Zamudio, who's this great dribbler, comfortable bringing the ball to the inside in order to switch the ball across. The pass is made, and instead of going all the way back to the touchline with a fullback out there, Zamudio's using some intelligence, right, but some tactical acumen to fill into this channel on the right side of Navarro to get himself back onto the ball. And now, because the defense is aligned the way it is, he's looking to carry the ball again, because that's how wingers work. That's what their instructions are as a role. And he's looking to carry the ball again to the outside. It's taken away, he gives the ball away, and he's going to receive the ball again, making a run in a more traditional winger position. This is lovely. This is exactly what we needed. He got into a narrow space to help facilitate our passing game, and he's passed his way all the way up the side and now makes a driving run into this area, which is where you'll normally find a winger on attack making plays from. If they're on the attack mentality, they're really going to look to cross from the byline a lot more often, which is where Zamudio can get to, because again, just in case you'd forgotten, it's always good to illustrate with examples. Let's slow this down here, because what's about to happen is really the key to why you clicked on this video and why the wingers are scoring. So when you have a winger on a narrow system, right, you're going to need somebody that's able to take this wide part away. So as the ball bounces out, Zamudio is still staying in this kind of offensive position. And if you do have fullbacks that get up, that winger is going to tuck further inside. If you have a fullback that's inverted or stays back, the winger is going to stay wider. Carbajal has the ball, and we're going to work the way our way back through the middle. We see Zamudio is drifting in. Now, you remember our formation. These are the three forwards. And the way that we set up when we're ultra offensive is we essentially end up with those three guys putting pressure against the back line. And it's exactly what the doctor ordered. So the midfielder, we're playing our low tempo kind of passing game. And now Clubinho hits this pass towards Zamudio. He takes this touch and he's headed inside. This is winger on narrow. He needs to have decent passing and able to play this way. But he gives the ball away. The entire back line, including their left back, have followed in because this is the winger, right? There's no passing off happening here. Clubinho finds Mendes. Mendes brings it in. And Zamudio, my winger on attack, is right in front of the goal for the finish. As a winger on attack, that's how you get them to score goals. Maybe that's not your goal. That's always been my goal when using wingers. But you can, in this system, right? If you maybe you wanted to go wider, right? And your right back isn't Lamine Mendes, a world-class passing right back, but instead is somebody you want helping out with defense because they've got some really talented winger who's just hanging out up here and you don't want to get torched on the counterattack. So you leave that person back. You play instead of narrow, you play more wide, and you maybe play on support so that they're crossing from deeper. This player is going to end up wider. But in the past two iterations of the game, wingers in any instance have been throwing themselves in the box to kind of wreak havoc. And so the idea of playing somebody as a winger is not a purely facilitating role anymore. This is somebody that is capable of scoring double digit goals per season, because when you're getting in this type of spot after laying the ball off, instead of going wide, drifting into the middle on narrow on winger, and then being able to make this run. I mean, this is a striker's run right here. Right into the edge of the box because we've got that fullback overlapping. You can successfully overlap a fullback around a winger in Football Manager 21. You can. And I'd imagine that that's something, because of the fluidity of the game, that's still going to be there in future iterations. This is not something that I knew was possible on Football Manager 21, really to this extent, because the way I set my team up, I want three primary goal scorers. You've got the forward on the left, the center forward, and then somebody on the right who is connecting play, is able to carry the ball, but is also able to score, which is why I've been using an inside forward earlier. But Zamudio was the most talented player to get into this position, so I tried to make it work, and that's how we've ended up with all of these different tips about how to help your winger score. Here's another way that this can look. So we're in sustained possession again, and when you've got a winger on attack on narrow, you see Jason Serna receives the ball. And Angel Zamudio starts to drop out to a winger position where he can receive the ball. But based off of his own intelligence and his own reading of the situation, Zamudio breaks this off as a winger on narrow is capable of doing in this spot, and makes a run behind the line. Now, Serna is just being a buffoon here. He doesn't see the run that would have been open if he'd managed to find this little caveat. But this is a fabulous run by Angel Zamudio, a striker goal scoring type run that you can get out of more narrow wingers or wider wingers on attack when you're in very sustained possession with overlapping fullbacks. Later in the same possession, and we'll play this a bit faster, we see him do it again. Serna receives the ball and Zamudio makes another striker's run in between the fullback and the center back, providing options for the playmakers on my team to try and pick him out. It's really incredible. And then he makes the run again and he scores. All of a sudden, wingers bagging goals. Also, beautiful spell of play by those Oriental Dragon boys. How about that, huh? How about it? But what if you have somebody that is not the pure ball-carrying missile down the right side? But you may want to watch the playmaker version of this video, where we're going to talk about playmakers all over the field at a later date. Or you might want to do something like an inside forward or an inverted winger, the types of classic players that end up in those wide positions. And in order to talk about that, we're going to have to talk about a different player. We're going to have to talk about Armando Pereira, who for the majority of the last two seasons at Oriental Dragon has spent his time running as an inside forward off the right with an overlapping fullback in Bruno Gama or Lamine Mendes. And we'll go back to earlier this season in a 2-2 draw against Sporting that at the time we should have won, and I'm frustrated that we did not, to get an understanding of how Armando Pereira was scoring so many goals at some point this year. And to the point that he was a player of the month as an inside forward. Now, what's important to note here is that we will also draw a difference between the narrow and wide setups that are possible here. Now, obviously, the narrow setup is what we're using with Angel Samudio as a winger, but with Armando Pereira as an inside forward, we used a wider setup, looking to really expand the field with our fullbacks because Pereira was eventually going to make his way inside. But what you'll notice is that Samudio was a much more immediate goal-scoring threat on the narrow setup because he was starting more narrow. As Walter Mabasso picks this ball up in the midfield, our boy Armando Pereira on the opposite side of the field is still holding a wide position. He is looking to make those forward runs, but he's looking to make those forward runs on the outside of the fullback, and then he's obviously able to score a goal from that position. But what's important to understand is that inside forwards will only really become inside forwards when they gain possession of the ball. They will also cut in and find similar positions to a winger on attack, as we've been talking about, and get into the box and be able to score. But if they are not in possession of the ball and picking it up and running with it consistently, they will still operate from those wide spaces, and once receiving the ball, look to cut it to their inside foot. In this case, he had enough space to do it. Great pass by Walter Mabasso, by the way. This does not preclude you from those sorts of in front of the goal finishes, though. You're going to get, obviously, just a little more of that from inside forwards because they are more aggressive. We have Mejia, our left back, carrying the ball, and now we have Armando Pereira starting to tuck into that position that we were seeing Angel Samudio get into. Now, granted, because of our wider setup, Armando Pereira is outside of the entire defensive setup, but given where the ball is, that entire defensive setup of Torpedo Shadzina in this case is shifted way, way to the right. So Armando Pereira is given this license to move in on that outside fullback, and as Ja Silva makes his driving run, the cross is in for Armando Pereira to finish it off at the back post. If you have one side that you're looking to overload on crossing, an inside forward is obviously more than capable of providing that finishing at the back post. But you're not necessarily going to lose that with a winger coming from generally the same area. So inside forwards have this like take more risk on, but that actually only applies to passing, as you see here. Their influence in terms of cutting in and being the next Arjen Robben is when they pick the ball up. They also have get further forward, but as you notice, the winger on attack and Angel Samudio also gets further forward and was able to get himself into the box. And especially the more narrow that your formation is, the more influential goal scorer your winger is going to be able to be while still contributing as a ball carrier on the outside instead of a ball carrier on the inside. And that is essentially the decision that you have to make. What we have found in playing these matches is that the goal output you can get from wings and inside forwards is incredibly similar. While wingers are going to look to cross more often and carry the ball on the outside in terms of an off-ball goal threat, they're like the same. Especially the more narrow a formation is, the more influential a winger gets as an off-ball goal threat, while an inside forward is kind of always going to be an off-ball goal threat because they don't have the stay wider in their instruction. And being able to score goals is usually about your ability to move off the ball and get into dangerous positions. Now, an interesting thing is that that fluidity positionally is going to offer you a bit more goal scoring, but that the inside forward isn't always going to be able to get it in onto their left foot. So let's watch this play. We've got Armando Pereira again, who's our cutting in winger example. Conch is able to pick him out. Pereira drops into a wide space. We know he's trying to get the ball to his left foot, but he's just unable to do it, right? He's an inside forward in this instance 100% of the time, and he is not able to cut inside of the defender in front of him. Instead, he lays it off and then gets inside of that defender and is able to finish off a deflected shot for a goal. But what we see later is that fluidity and movement again, where Pereira drops into this wide position. Jairo Concha, an all-time legend, hits it here, and Angel Samudio hits a glancing header. Now, a lot of this play is going to come down to the fact that Armando Pereira is an incredibly high work rate, high stamina player. It's the 93rd minute. When this glancing header is put into an area, Armando Pereira is going to score essentially, one of the two types of goals inside forwards can score that, well, wingers just can't. And that one is the Arjen Robben goal, where you bring it in on your left foot and then shoot or facilitate with that take more risks and looking to pass more. And the other is Armando Pereira actually diving in on this ball because he does not have in any sense that stay wider that will at least slightly lock him into that position. It is incredibly unlikely you will see a winger score that type of goal. If you have a central forward that is looking to drop in, an inside forward is going to have that bit more freedom to fill that space than a winger is ever we're going to have. The winger is going to be making that run, but they will never make the run all the way across the face of the goal. And then there is the spot in the middle, the one that we haven't really used with Oriental Dragon, so I don't have as many examples to show you. But what we can talk about and look at is what the inverted winger looks like when they receive the ball in terms of what they do, as opposed to what the inside forward looks like when they receive the ball with that I'm going to cut in and try and make a play sort of thing going on. So the inverted winger likes to dribble more. They cut inside and they get further forward, but they're inherently less aggressive than an inside forward, because an inside forward has the one, cross less often, and two, take more risks. The take more risks is a passing thing, just to understand what's going on. And inside forwards, because of the way they favor their foot, they tend to, you get in and shoot across the goal more than a winger that'll shoot that way. You understand. An inverted winger is still going to look to cross. So what you'll often see, if I just haven't played inverted wingers, but it's because I haven't had a player that I wanted to, is if I took Angel Samudio, right, and I switched up this tactic, and I put Herrera over here, and then I just brought Samudio back from the dead, wherever he happens to be, and I put him here. Right, Angel Samudio is in this spot. Well, now all of a sudden an inverted winger makes sense, because Angel Samudio is already a winger. We want him hard driving. We want him getting by people and then making crosses. Well, what an inverted winger does is they do look to cut inside with the ball, but they aren't discouraged from crossing it. So they'll get into a position where they look like they can play the ball across, and instead of trying to drive the ball towards the middle of the field, they'll loft a ball towards the back post or try and pick a through ball or a pass from maybe the edge of the 18. Now, an inverted winger can, of course, score plenty of goals on attack. They also have get further forward, which can make them influential in the final third of the field. The more narrow the formation, the more influential they are, right? They can score the types of goals that inside forwards score. The key difference is that they do look to cross. And if you have a winger that you want to put on the other side of the field, because I don't know, maybe your fullback is weaker on that side, or you feel like their fullback is weaker on that side, or you have your super tall striker who's in the opposite side of there, so that when you are in possession, right, if you're more of a possession-based team, an inverted winger makes more sense than a winger, because they'll get all the way to the byline, but they'll cut it back and be able to cross that way instead of trying to get ahead of the defender to cross with their outside foot. That is the key difference. Now, an inverted winger, I would say, is closer to a winger than an inside forward because of that encouragement to cross and the fact that they naturally start wide. They're going to look to cross the ball a lot more. Inside forwards grab the ball, they get inside. And of course, once they get inside, they'll often stay there. The ball comes back out to a fullback and you've got somebody extra on the inside of the box. And here's a nice last example of what you can expect from an inside forward. We'll put the speed on a little lower so we can just go ahead and watch this. The ball is distributed by Chavez, goalkeeper. It's terrible. Pereira picks it up. He's a couple steps from the touchline. But as an inside forward who is not looking to cross at any point, he's going to come inside and he is not going to just loft the ball, try and pick out back post or play at a bit lower tempo. No, he's going to grab this ball and he is going to attack the fullback. Now, he wasn't good enough on this occasion to get by the guy, but fortunately our Chinese superstar He Xin is there, and Armando Pereira continues to drive on that trajectory with his favored inside foot and attacks that space and is able to score the goal. So creating the emphasis in the inside of the field, and again, once they get there, they'll tend to stay there. So if they pick the ball up, carry it into the middle, and then it ends up with somebody else, they're already there. They're not going to go back out most of the time unless the ball gets completely recycled. Especially if there's a fullback on the outside of them, they'll leave the fullback in that space. This is why when you play inside forwards, this creates more of the emphasis on the inside, but it doesn't mean that you can't score with wingers or inverted wingers. Those are the three most common winger roles that are used in Football Manager, and you can score a lot of goals with all three of them. But if you play with a winger on support and use it as a facilitator and have people from the midfield making runs instead, you can also use them as a playmaking role, which is something that we'll talk about in another video. Yay! Hopefully you'll be able to get a lot more goals from your wingers, or at least understand the difference between the different types of wings, so that you can best use the players that you have on your team to either create goals or create opportunities for other people, or get people involved in the box, or finally realize that there's this whole attacking width thing that you probably should have been paying attention to.